2. When Arthur got back to the classroom, his friends rushed to his side. "You survived," said Buster, "with no obvious signs of torture." Binky added, "He looks a little disappointed. What happened?" asked Francine. Arthur let out a sigh. "Mr. Henry gave me this." He held up a large brown envelope. He said it was for my mom. "That's it?" asked Muffy. She reached out for a closer look. "What does it say? It is sealed?" Francine grabbed the envelope. "It's sealed all right." She held up the light and too thick to read through. "Give it a shake," said Buster, cocking his ears. Francine shook the envelope for a moment. It rushed softly. "That doesn't tell us much," she said. Binky forked his arms. "Let's just open it." "I can't," said Arthur. "It's addressed to my mother. And look what's stamped on it. Private and confidential." "That's a bad sign," said Buster. "Good news is never private." "Besides," said Binky, "you can't start making excuses until you know what kind of trouble you're in." "Didn't Mr. Henry give you any clues at all?" Francine asked. "He said it was important," said Arthur, taking back the envelope. "That was about it." "If it was good news," said Muffy, "Mr. Henry would have told you. My mother always told me right away if you got a new limousine or if Cook is making a special dessert for dinner." "He didn't say anything like that," Arthur admitted. "That means it's bad news," said Francine. "The question is, how bad is it?" This was a mad question Arthur wanted to think about. Binky laughed. "Oh, I bet you lost your library book. I don't think Mr. Henry gets involved with overdue library books," said Arthur. "Besides, I just wrote mine." "Oh no," said Francie. "What?" said Muffy. "Tell us," said Buster. "Tell me," said Arthur. "Never mind," said Francie. It's too terrible to think about." Arthur turned pale. "That's why you have to tell me." "All right," said Francie. "You forced me into it," she shuddered. "What if you didn't pass Mr. Redburn's history test?" Arthur frowned. The big test had been the week before. It had been a hard one. "Remember, Arthur, you told me afterward that you wrote how two pilgrims came to America in 1620. "Francine, the pilgrim did came to America in 1620. She looked surprised. "Really?" Everyone noticed. "Well, still," Franz tapped the envelope. "The proof is right here. And if you fail the test, you might fail the whole year. You know what that means, summer school." Arthur sat down his chair and thought about his face. Summer school. Probably the two most dreaded words in the English language. He saw himself chained to a world of dark dungeon. Outside the bar window, he could hear his friends playing. He looked out through the bars. Buster and the Brain were setting up the tent for camping. Muffy and Prunella were rollerblading. Arthur looked around his cell. He was alone, with only some thick, dusty books for company. Then the guard, Mr. Redburn, walked in. He was making ice cream from a cone. A few drops fell on the stones, just behind Arthur's reach. "Snap out of it, Arthur," said Francine. Arthur looked at his friends winkling. You know what they say, being Buster wanted. Those who don't learn history or doomed to report it are docile, history or not. He felt doomed for sure.